Thanks very much for taking a look at this video. And what I want to do real briefly is answer a question that so many people ask all the time. And it has to do with regard to fatty liver disease, non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. And is there a specific diet that they need to follow? Now, everybody wants a relatively quick fix to a serious medical condition. And a lot of people will look at diet or supplements or the way they eat as a remedy or a solution to the problem. Though in this particular condition, non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, I must say that from a nutritional and diet standpoint, it makes sense to address the dietary concerns and having the right diet to try to reverse fatty liver disease or at least to prevent further progression of the disease. Now, as a quick backdrop, and there are other videos that we have regarding non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, and I would also say that in the near future, we're going to have a video talking specifically about therapies and some new therapies with regard to clinical research that we're involved in. So stay tuned for that. But today we're going to be talking about diet. Now, when you look at non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, the driving force behind developing fatty liver or the risk factor for fatty liver is certainly going to be obesity. It's going to be insulin resistance. That is a situation in your body where you're not quite able to handle the glucose and fat load that your body takes, and it has difficulty breaking down, absorbing, and utilizing the glucose in your body. So think of insulin resistance as a spectrum within type 2 diabetes from the earliest stages, which could be considered insulin resistance or pre-diabetes, all the way through type 2 diabetes. And there are a number of different mechanisms why somebody develops fatty liver disease, starting with the insulin resistance, increased oxidative stress, free radicals, high cholesterol, high triglycerides, the improper metabolism of these lipids with your LDL cholesterol, HDL, VLDL cholesterol, and other hormones that are very, very important in our metabolism, our digestion, and the proper handling of fats and lipids in the body. Now, as far as a diet, if you are looking for what needs to be done, what do you need today to try to help yourself with non-alcoholic fatty liver disease? Without a doubt, it's going to be transitioning to a plant-based diet. This is going to be a diet that is rich in fruits and vegetables, and we always talk about a very colorful diet with a wide range of vegetables and a wide range of fruits, and most likely the elimination of beef, chicken, and pork and other red meats. The data is pretty overwhelming that those that are on the diets high in fruit, high in vegetables, a paucity of meat are going to do well. Now, whether or not you want to introduce and have lean fish, that would probably be okay too. But the main driver here, which we talk about all the time, is that we have become a society, a nation, a world that is very much dependent on cheap processed foods. Processed foods where the nutrients, the fiber, the vitamins, the minerals are extracted from it, and we're eating processed food. We have really lost ourselves as far as cooking at home and eating fresh fruits and vegetables and teaching our children how to appreciate the fresh fruits and vegetables. Research has shown, the experience shows, that people that are eating a diet with various fruits, various vegetables, devoid of meat, are going to lose weight. Their insulin resistance is going to become under control. They're going to be much more sensitive. Instead of resistant to insulin, they're going to be insulin sensitive. With the weight loss, their lipids, their blood sugar, cholesterol, triglycerides are going to come down. There's going to be less oxidative stress, less free radicals circulating around the body, creating havoc, not only in the liver, but throughout the entire body. Every organ is going to be affected during this metabolic storm that so many are going through, which leads to fatty liver and chronic heart disease, increased risk of kidney disease, bone disease, lung disease, and cancer. So the strategy has to be to, in a sense, wean yourself off the processed foods, the eating out. And as I have said many, many times in the past, eating out really is a hazard to your health. You have to be very, very careful when you go out to eat at a restaurant that you are not getting a meal that is overly processed with too much fat or a diet that is going to promote obesity, an obesogenic diet. There certainly are many resources online to find recipes that are rich in fruits and vegetables, and it really takes time. And you have to really look at yourself and say, my life really depends on my nutrition. My life depends on me getting these kinds of situations under control. You have to look at the convenience of eating out, the convenience of frozen foods, the convenience of popping a meal in the microwave. That convenience is going to lead to a very troubling existence if you are developing these chronic diseases such as fatty liver disease, which has the potential to lead to cirrhosis, more advanced chronic liver disease, and the development of cirrhosis. And we certainly do not want to get there. What I would say is be mindful to stay away from these fad diets, these commercially diets that we all read about and we hear online and in social media. There really is no special fad diet that somebody is claiming that is working better for them. What I would say is certainly look at the Mediterranean diet, which is going to be a diet rich in fruit, rich in vegetables, nuts, olives, olive oil. That would be one to really master and understand. But all of the other diets of the week or diet of the month that you read about, and there's a million books out there, I would be very, very leery. Fresh fruit, fresh vegetables, avoid meat, and you will lose weight and get all of these metabolic issues under control and potentially reverse fatty liver. So that is it. Please subscribe to our videos on YouTube so you don't miss a single video that we post. And of course, visit drjoegalati.com, sign up for a newsletter, and all of the other health and wellness and liver-related material that we want to share with you. Stay well, continued good health, and of course, if you have any questions, don't hesitate to contact me and my team here at Liver Specialists of Texas. Our mission is to help the public, help our patients and their families get the knowledge, education, and therapy that they deserve. Take care, and we'll see you soon.